I'm Josh the Fox Mills, and this is Toon'd, where I review cartoons, no matter how new, no matter how old, no matter the cost. Well, it seems I still have a bit of a ghost problem, and since hired help seemed to be a dead end, I think, why not try a superhero? Yes, this next cartoon is a super tune! To take a look at Butch Hartman's supernatural do-gooder Danny Phantom, but before we get to that, it's time to see my name repeatedly during the opening credits. On Nickelodeon, Danny Phantom ran for 53 episodes and 3 seasons. The show finally ended in 2007 officially. Let's talk about the theme song right away.
Young Danny Phantom, he was just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine.
It was designed to view a world unseen.
He's gonna catch a mold disease, Danny Phantom.
When it didn't quite work, his folks, they just quit.
But then Danny took a look inside of it.
There was a great big flash, everything just changed.
His molecules got all rearranged.
Ugh, a rap theme. This often doesn't work, but I have to say this time, it does at least a little. The show centers around Danny Fenton, a 14-year-old high school student living in Amity Park, Indiana. Yeah, Indiana. I didn't know that either. His parents are an eccentric pair of ghost hunters. Said parents, Maddie and Jack Fenton, had an entire basement laboratory dedicated to ghosts. In this lab sat the Ghost Portal, a dimensional gateway that opened to the so-called Ghost Zone, where all ghosts reside. After some pressure from his friend, the goth girl Sam Manson, Danny decides to explore the Ghost Portal, which up to this point was considered a failed experiment. While inside the device, he accidentally manages to turn it on, infusing his DNA with ghostly ectoplasm, and turning him into the spectral superhero Danny Phantom. In ghost form, Danny is able to use a variety of ghost-related abilities, like fly, become invisible, become intangible, possess other people, and various other abilities that he learns how to use over time. As usual, where there are heroes, there are also villains. Here are a few of Danny Phantom's rogue gallery. Vlad Masters, a college friend to Jack Fenton who was in a similar accident to Danny's back in the 80s. Since then, he became Vlad Plasmius, a more experienced and therefore more powerful version of Danny Phantom. He serves as the main villain of the series. Ember McLean, a rock star ghost based off of the Irish Banshee. She can allure, repel, create, and destroy with her voice and her wicked guitar solos. Skulker, the Ghost Zone's greatest hunter. This ghost wears a metal suit full of high-tech gadgets to capture his prey. Inside his suit is a very tiny ghost with an inferiority complex. The last one I'm going to take a look at is the Box Ghost, a joke villain. He is apparently the remains of a dead warehouse shipper from a company like UPS or FedEx. He is obsessed with boxes and constantly yells at people to beware! There was a theory that because Danny became half-ghost that he was also half-dead. Others have covered this theory before and debunked it, but they've always done it in a way that left me dissatisfied. Yes, Danny is quite alive, and didn't die in his accident, but we're talking half-dead, not all dead. What's the difference? Well, according to the Princess Bride, mostly dead still means partially alive. The point is, I think there may be some weight to this theory, but the real question is, does it really even matter? Anyway, Danny must balance his new superhero duties with his school and social life. Luckily, Danny is not alone in this, as 3 people know his secret identity and are willing to help him. Sam Manson, The goth girl I mentioned earlier is Danny's best friend, and it is constantly hinted at they could become something more. Tucker Foley, Danny's other friend and techie super nerd. He provides both the comic relief and the technological support. And Jazz Fenton, Danny's 16-year-old sister, who is often overprotective but ultimately supporting and caring. The team had to defeat villains and send those monsters back into the ghost zone. And now, we're in the host zone. It's time to find out...
What does the fox say?
Danny Phantom was critically acclaimed, and for good reason. Its use of comic book style writing and action provided for a very entertaining show that many are sad to see go, including myself. It is a fun paranormal action tune, and I highly recommend you see it for yourself. I don't want to get too ahead of myself, but there are rumors going around that they're trying to make a sequel series to Danny Phantom. Fingers crossed, maybe. Well, Ghost Month comes to a close next week. What anime could I possibly use? There are so many to choose from. Well, you're gonna have to find out next week. Until then, stay tuned.